SpaceX and Elon Musk are on a mission to conquer Mars with an enormous rocket that's larger than the Statue of Liberty. You heard that right. Larger than the Statue of Liberty. But how big exactly is the Starship rocket? And even more importantly, where can we expect to see SpaceX's final spacecraft? Well, we'll find out in just a second. But before that, please don't forget to subscribe to our channel Futurephile to watch more fascinating videos on futuristic tech. On May the 28th, Musk shared a photo of his latest Starship prototype, the SN16, which is being prepared for the project's biggest test yet, the Mars-bound ship's first orbital flight. The 50-meter-long stainless steel spaceship is shown in a hangar at Musk's Starbase facility in Boca Chica, Texas, with its sci-fi nose cone and fins projected against the night sky. Alongside the SN16 was a booster, which will help propel the ship into space. Combining Starship with the Super Heavy booster will make it the most powerful launch vehicle ever developed, taking the crown from the massive Saturn V rocket system used by NASA in the 1960s and 1970s to take humans to the moon. As per SpaceX, fully reusable Starship and Super Heavy systems are expected to allow for space-based activities that have not been possible since the retirement of the Space Shuttle and Space Transportation System, or have never been possible before. With a fully reusable Starship, satellites can be captured and repaired in orbit, returned to Earth, or transferred to a new operational orbit. Well indeed, Musk's goal is overly ambitious yet revolutionary. However, the greater the goal, the greater the effort, and that is something Musk is well aware of. Musk's effort dates back to 2001. In 2001, Musk conceptualized Mars OASIS, a project to land a miniature experimental greenhouse containing seeds with dehydrated gel on Mars to grow plants on Martian soil. If successful, the project would produce the first oxygen on Mars and would serve Musk's greater goal of reigniting public interest in human space exploration. Thus, in late October 2001, Musk traveled to Russia with the hope of buying 3 intercontinental ballistic missiles for $20 million. But the Russians did not take the young millionaire seriously, and no deal was ever made. Instead, Musk set about creating SpaceX to build his rockets for a fraction of the price. Nearly 2 decades later, and roughly $200 billion richer, Musk is on the cusp of building a rocket capable of interplanetary space travel, and has already secured a multi-billion dollar contract with NASA to use it to land astronauts on the moon. Starship is currently humanity's best chance of reaching Mars, with no other private company or government space agency yet to put a program in place that will send humans any further than the moon. Although SpaceX only started testing Starship prototypes in January 2020, it has done so at a breakneck pace. Following 2 successful 150-meter hops at its Boca Chica, Texas Starbase facility, the company launched a series of high-altitude flight tests at a rate of approximately 1 per month. The first 4 of these ended in explosions, but each one marked a major step forward in the construction of the spacecraft. However, on May 5, 2021, the string of failures finally came to an end when the Starship prototype SN15 successfully completed its high-altitude test without exploding. And now, as the goal of reaching orbit is becoming more realistic, SpaceX is exploring a variety of options for the upcoming Starship test schedule. Following the successful test of Starship SN15, the options include reflying the spacecraft to achieve critical reusability objectives, launching SN16 to a greater altitude, or proceeding to orbital testing on Super Heavy. It's impossible to predict what SpaceX will do next. However, with traces of what may be SN20, supposedly the first orbital Starship seen around Starbase, the focus is now heavily on getting to orbit. And if that is the case, we can expect the orbital launch to be completed soon enough. That's because, as per the flight profile stated in the FCC filing, the Starship orbital test flight will originate from Starbase TX. The booster stage will separate approximately 170 seconds into flight. The booster will then perform a partial return and land in the Gulf of Mexico, approximately 20 miles from the shore. The orbital Starship will continue on flying between the Florida Straits. It will achieve orbit until performing a powered targeted landing approximately 100 kilometers, roughly 62 miles, off the northwest coast of Kauai on a soft ocean landing. Any potential leap from SN15 to the orbital attempt would have the added benefit of minimizing disturbance to the launch tower construction efforts. with SpaceX undertaking the path it used during the first Falcon 9 booster landings with a soft touchdown on water, flight testing is no longer an issue. The teams can focus on finishing the ground service equipment. In fact, they are making the most of this situation, as seen by photos posted on Twitter. This week, a third section was attached to the tower, with several more prefabricated sections to follow. The tower will eventually be the highest building in the vicinity of South Padre Island. Once completed, the launch tower will be responsible for launching the fully stacked Starship and catching the first stage booster on its return. On top of the tower, a 10-foot lightning rod will ensure that the vehicles on the ground are protected from any lightning strikes. This will guarantee that vehicles on the launch pad remain safe in the event of a lightning strike, as happened in May last year when a bolt struck the ground just next to the Starship SN4 prototype. And even more importantly, SpaceX will use the launch tower arm to catch the future Super Heavy booster. Musk says, "We're going to try to catch the Super Heavy booster with the launch tower arm, using the grid fins to take the load. Designing, building and qualifying mechanical arms that are simultaneously strong, gentle and reliable enough to endure the weight of several hundred ton rockets carrying substantial momentum is an extreme challenge. SpaceX's first stage booster alone will be 230 feet tall, accounting for more than half of the fully stacked launch vehicle platform's height. The final variant of the booster will be powered by 29 Raptor engines. However, according to Musk's tweet, Super Heavy will now have 29 engines on its aft." He also added that Super Heavy will eventually grow to house 32 engines. Musk says 29 Raptors on booster initially, rising to 32 later this year, along with thrust increase per engine. Aiming for more than 7,500-ton thrust long-term, TW roughly 1.5. The supply line for this engine demand is being focused at the production site at SpaceX headquarters in Hawthorne, California. Musk added that Raptor production is approaching one every 48 hours, most likely a reference to one Raptor rolling off the production line every 48 hours. NASA spaceflight's Gary Blair in the L2 McGregor section captured photographs of Raptors in all three bays, including what looks to be another new Raptor VAC engine. This indicates that work on the spacecraft is speeding up, and we might see the first orbital flight sooner than we expected. Once completed, the Starship would launch from an ocean spaceport, Deimos. Named after one of the moons of Mars, Deimos will be the result of the transformed oil rig that SpaceX purchased earlier this year. It is already under construction and could launch operations next year. When completed, Starship and Super Heavy will be the world's most powerful launch vehicle ever developed. The Starship would be just below 400 feet long with its booster. To put it in perspective, it would be almost 100 feet taller than the Statue of Liberty. It will have the ability to carry 100 to 150 metric tons to Earth orbit, which is 10 metric ton more payload than Saturn V rocket. It will also be 10 meters longer than the Saturn V. But while the Saturn V took more than $1 billion to build and make a flight, according to Elon, the Starship is expected to cost only $2 million per mission. Let that sink in. That would be 500 times cheaper. This is the ultimate promise of Starship. Way better payload carrying capability at a fraction of the cost. Musk wants to send an unmanned Starship rocket to Mars by 2022, followed by manned missions by 2024. This might seem overly ambitious, but let's not forget, Musk has a reputation for eventually achieving his goals. If you like watching this video, you may also watch the video on Starship's Super Heavy booster, shown in the end screen. See you there.